As extreme weather events like flooding and wildfires increase in frequency, being prepared to evacuate your home at a moment's notice is more critical than ever, especially if you've got pets to worry about in addition to two-legged family members. So I want to bring in a good friend of the show, Dr. Ruth McPeat, veterinarian and author of Lizette the Vet. Dr. McPeat, thanks so much for joining us. A lot of times these emergencies are a matter of moments, so you really need to have everything together. So before an emergency, what are the things that pet owners need to be thinking about to prepare and to have on standby?
Well, the first thing people need to do is make sure all pets have identification. So collars with ID tags and microchips are a must for all pets. The next thing is that it's really important that people have a disaster kit for themselves and also their pets. And it's really easy to do. To make a disaster kit, all you're going to need is a backpack to store your supplies. You want to make sure that you're putting food and water, several days worth of food and water for your pet, not forgetting to include bowls for food and water. I recommend using collapsible bowls because they're lightweight and easy to store. Another thing that you're going to want to put in that disaster kit are treats for your pet. You pick your pet's favorite treats and their favorite toy. And this is really important because a lot of pets hide during an emergency or disaster, and you can use these treats and toys to entice them to come out of hiding. The next thing that's really important that people include when they're preparing is a leash to secure their pet. If you have cats or small to medium-sized dogs, you want to have a carrier on hand. This is a great one. This is a Sherpa Elevation carrier. What I like about it is that it's actually a carrier and a backpack, so you can put your pet in it, grab and go, and you can actually put all of the supplies inside of it as well. The next thing that people need to make sure they don't forget is medication for their pet. If your pet's on any medication, thyroid meds, medication for arthritis, flea, tick, and heartworm preventatives, you want to include that in your kit because you may not be able to get to your veterinarian in an emergency. And the same thing with including a pet first aid kit.
Dr. McPeat, a lot of times when there's a disaster that's impending, whether it be, say, a hurricane or a wildfire, you may be asked to evacuate. That's an anxious time for us humans, right? We get very nervous. How do we keep our pets calm so they don't become an issue for the family?
Well, easier said than done, but you want to try to be as calm as you can be in that situation. Being prepared is really key. If all you need to do is grab your disaster kit and your pet and go, that's going to make it a lot easier for you, a lot less stressful for you in that situation. So that's really key. There are a number of different calming products out there that are available that you can get over the counter, or you can talk to your veterinarian about medication as well, or calming shirts or different products that you can use if you have a very anxious pet. It's also important that people include in their kits, they want to also have important documents, so their vaccine history and their microchip information as well.
Dr. McPeat, some of these are very short fuse warnings, and a lot of times after a severe storm or a fire, people say, oh, I wasn't able to find the cat or the dog. Do you recommend having the pet with you as that risk goes up?
Yes, definitely. That's a great idea. If you know that there is a tornado warning, the best thing is to have your pets with you in the basement or wherever you're taking shelter, have them with you. Same thing with if you know that there is fire danger, you want to have your pets close by so that you can grab them and go. And again, it's really about being ready at a moment's notice. So having this disaster kit, having your carrier, having everything ready to go so that you can grab your pet, use the treats to get them and get them out and get out of the house as quickly as possible.
How can we help our pet then cope, or maybe have our pets help us cope with a change in venue, right? We're maybe staying with a family member, a friend, maybe we're staying at a shelter. How do you get your furry friend accustomed to that living situation?
Well, bringing things that are theirs is really key. So having food that they normally eat is really important. That's why you want to pack that in your disaster kit, because you don't want to have to change foods because that may upset their stomach. Bringing a blanket that's your pet's, bringing toys and treats, those things are going to help as well to keep your pet grounded. And obviously being with you is the most important things. Our pets really want to be with us, and so being together is key.
Real quick, we got to let you go, but could you introduce your little friend?
This is Jet, my little buddy.
He's always so well behaved.
He is. He is pretty mellow.
Yeah, and his T-shirt's adorable. Well, Dr. Ruth McPhee, yeah. Veterinarian, author of Lizette the Vet, we always appreciate having you. We always appreciate having Jet, too.
Thank you so much. Nice to see you guys. Be safe.